People do throw around contextual advertising a lot these days. And, you know, Google was obviously in the news a week ago pushing back the phase out of cookies. But this is an issue that's long been brewing, right? Safari and Firefox block cookies by default 2 years ago. Solutions like Universal ID really haven't picked up enough, and the match rates are, you know, kind of crap. You look at the consumer, they are driving a major push around privacy right now. In fact, Congress may be acting soon with the American Data Privacy and Protection Act. We could talk about that in a little bit. But CTech takes a different approach to contextual. We were born contextual. And we think about it much differently than the typical approach of keyword targeting. We really want to understand what's happening through the written word and the images on the open web. So we have a full network understanding by the AI platform that we call Liz. It's able to understand the categories that are garnering the most consumer interest, what's trending, brand suitability and safety obviously come by default with what we do. But we are a full stack solution that uses the power of the platform to do advanced contextual targeting, going beyond keyword targeting. We have premium access to inventory and placements on a page. And we have a whole creative studio with amazing developers and creatives that can tie a unique message to that unique content so it drives attention and engagement.
So, Brian, what is the application of CTag to the buy side and the sell side?
Yeah, so for the buy side, you know, we see briefs all the time from advertisers that want to get very, very granular with their audiences. They design these audience targets that have very deep looks at varied interests and concerns and habits, right? They go far beyond the 700 or so categories that the IAB has in their taxonomy. So, for example, an advertiser like Visa may be interested in reaching people that are focused on sustainability, right? Well, sustainability may technically fall under a category like environmentalism, but environmentalism can mean climate change, it can mean pollution. Sustainability can be a part of that, but it's not the same thing. So if we really want to understand what the consumer cares about and where they are consuming this type of content, the AI of our platform can get very, very granular on those content pages and make sure there's a deeper connection. The same for brand suitability and brand safety. Look, the word shoot can mean something very different when having content covering the war in Ukraine or unfortunate incidents that happen in this country a lot with shootings versus shooting a basketball, right? And words in the English language can have many different meanings, and that's why you need an AI to really understand it all. On the supply side, you know, I think it opens up a ton of possibilities for publishers to open up their content and their supply to the demand side in more profound ways. They can understand what people are talking about and having interest in. So that can inform their editorial department. They can find what may be triggering brand safety issues and make changes based upon that. They can look at what competitor suppliers may be doing and what people are talking about and make adjustments. So there's a lot to learn in terms of what people are consuming on the open web, because that's where 70% of consumption is still happening. And if you are giving the right signals to both the supply and demand side, I think you can make more harmonious connections between them.
So, Brian, you guys raised a significant amount through private equity recently. What does the raise mean, and what could we expect from CTAG in the U.S. market, and what does the roadmap look for you?
Yeah, we're really excited about the commitment that Advent made to us. We think this is indicative of and confirmation of our unique approach to contextual, and quite frankly, in an environment where it is tough to raise money, you know, given you know, the potential for a U.S. recession. This is going to help us massively accelerate our U.S. expansion. You know, we're already in 11 countries around the world, the U.S. obviously being the largest ad market, and it's important for us to win this. So we're going to reinforce our team, develop our technology, and continue on with our mission of building the best platform in this country to satisfy both supply, demand, and make a better experience for users as well.